In this video, we're going to talk about the difference between power and torque, and to demonstrate the point, we've got a Harley-Davidson Heritage Classic 114, which is 114 cubic inches, just over 1.8 litres, and the Honda CB650R.
So in basic, simple terms, torque is how much turning force an engine can produce, and power is how fast the engine can produce that torque.
In the real world, power is what makes an engine go fast, and torque is what makes it feel fast.
Engines that produce a lot of power for their size usually have not as much torque, and that torque that it does have comes in at higher RPMs. So if you're going up a steep hill, you're most likely going to have to change down to get the most out of the engine, whereas on a more torquey engine, it will just plow up the hill.
Now, a high torque engine like this on the Harley may not rev as quickly as the Honda, but when you open the throttle, it still gives you a massive shove in the back. Now, both these bikes produce about the same brake horsepower, about 94 horsepower, but it's the torque that really sets them apart and is the main difference, which we'll go into now.
So the Honda produces its peak torque at 8,500 RPM, which is 64 newton meters of torque, and all of its power comes in at 12,000 RPM, which is really, really high revving.
Now the Heritage Classic produces 161 newton meters of torque, which is 119 foot-pounds, but that maximum torque comes in at only 3,000 RPM. So compare that to the Honda, where the maximum torque is 8,500 RPM. You can see that a slow, lazy, torquey engine produces everything low down, which is why on a cruiser you could be on the motorway at 70 miles an hour and it's just ticking over. So it's effortless riding for long distances, and it's a very comfortable ride, whereas on the Honda you've got to be revving the nuts off of it all the time to keep it in its power band.
The Honda will go from 0 to 60 in about 3.5 seconds, depending on the rider. And the Harley will do 0-60 in about 4.4 seconds. Now this being a lot more of a higher revving engine, this will be around 12,000 RPM when it's doing 60, whereas the Harley will probably be doing 4,000 RPM. But that's not a bad thing in either aspect, it's just purely the way the engine works.
Now to help understand, we are simplifying things, but to help sort of make it easy to understand, let's use an analogy. Imagine the Harley is Dwayne Johnson, the Rock, whereas the Honda is Christian Coleman, the fastest sprinter in the world at 60 metres. This is Christian Coleman, the Harley is Dwayne Johnson. Now, if they both had a sprint race, Christian Coleman would win.
Who's that? Who's Christian Coleman?
He's the fastest man in the world to 60 metres.
60 metres?
Yeah.
Who's that?
He's fast.
What about Usain Bolt?
Well, he's retired. So, think of it that way. So in a race, Christian Coleman is going to beat Dwayne Johnson. But if Dwayne Johnson put Christian Coleman on his back and walked up a hill, he wouldn't notice, he wouldn't feel it particularly. Whereas if Christian Coleman put Dwayne Johnson on his back and tried to walk up the same hill, he'd be, this is getting a bit heavy. So the torque of Dwayne Johnson gives you that sort of rhinoceros-like feeling, whereas the power of Christian Coleman is more like a cheetah who can blindingly quickly get out of the start gate and catch a wild animal of whatever wild animals cheetahs eat.
Now with the Harley, if you had a passenger on the back and lots of luggage, you wouldn't really notice the difference in weight. Because of the torque, it makes it effortless. So if you're going up a hill, you still probably wouldn't need to change down a gear or overtaking again. You just blast past them without needing to change down. Now with a more powerful bike like this, it's more about fast acceleration and getting to high speeds and sort of keeping it in that power band where you get the rapid response. Whereas with something like this, where it's more torquey, it's more about sitting at low RPMs on the motorway and just effortlessly going along.
we kind of got two camps here. We got the Harley and the Honda, the sports bike and the cruiser. And often the type of rider that rides each bike hates the other type. We don't. We like all bikes and we're not like that. But what a lot of people that hate Harleys don't understand is that Harley could be more powerful, could even be more torquey, but it's built for long-lasting cruising, and you can go vast distances on it and sit at the motorway at very low RPM. And obviously the more stressed the engine, the more service you would need to give it. So they're designed just to keep going sluggishly almost, but I mean they're still very fast. So if you've never ridden one, you can feel the torque, it's massive. Whereas on a sports bike, it's obviously more power and more buzzy, and obviously lots of fun. It's about racing, it's about going fast, it's about accelerating. You know, the two are very different, and they're for different purposes. So one isn't better or worse than the other, they're just completely different. Like, I'm different from somebody else. The bikes are the same, you know, there's no prejudice here. Now, to use another analogy, imagine if I went to a sports centre and we went to the racetrack and I was going to race a 12-year-old girl. She would beat me in a sprint race, she'd be faster than I would be. But then after that we went to the gym and we had some heavy weights and I was squatting some weight. I would be able to squat more than she could lift off the rack. So I would have more torque because I can lift heavier weights, she would have more power because she can move quicker.
So if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do.